Good morning po, and welcome sa ating daily devotional. There must be a big distinction between a believer and unbeliever, a righteous from the wicked, light from darkness, and those who love God and hate God. That's why our topic for today is the righteous and the wicked contrasted. Makikita po natin to sa Psalms chapter 1. Ati pong basahin, in verse 1, blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the wicked, nor stands in the way of sinners, nor sits in the seat of scoffers. But his delight is in the law of the Lord, and on his law he meditates day and night. He is like a tree planted by streams of water that yields its fruit in its season, and its leaf does not wither. In all that he does, he prospers. The wicked are not so, but are like the shaft that the wind drives away. Therefore, the wicked will not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the wicked will perish. There are things that we shouldn't do and must do to remain righteous and blessed. What does blessed mean? Blessed means fortunate, prosperous, and favored by God. Righteous people are prosperous and favored by God. But there are things that we shouldn't do. Kamukha po nang nabasa natin sa Psalms chapter 1. Blessed is the man who does not. So there are things that we shouldn't do. What are these? First, walk in the counsel of the wicked. Believers should not follow the advice of the wicked because they will lead us to destruction. We have our spiritual leaders, our mentors, our pastors to guide and help us whenever we need some advice. Kung may desisyon ka na kailangan gawin at nangangailangan ka ng gabay, huwag kang lumapit sa mga hindi kapwa mananampalataya. Huwag kang mahiyang tumingin ng tulong sa ating mga leader, sa ating mga pastor. Dahil ang mga taong to ay hindi kanila hayaan na mapahamak. Another is, we shouldn't follow the lifestyle of the wicked, the way they lived. They shouldn't be our role model. Sometimes, we are not aware na nagagaya natin yung mga ginagawa ng mga wicked. For example, whatever they wear, you wear. Whatever they say, you say. Whatever they do, you also want to do it. Ang mga taong namumuhay sa immoralidad at makamundo ay dapat walang impluensya sa ating buhay. These people must not have influence in our lives. Minsan hindi mo napapansin na yung mga kilos mo, yung mga pananalita mo, pananamit mo, your choices, ay dahil yan sa impluensya nila sa atin. Let us not forget that our identity is in Christ. He is our ultimate model. If there is someone that we must imitate, that must be Jesus. Let us have the mind of Christ and let us live the way Jesus lived. Number 2, let us not stand in the way of the sinners. A believer should be able to discern the right path to take. It involves wisdom and self-control to not choose the paths that are taken by the sinners. Sabi nga, mayroong daang makitid, pero sa dulo ay liwanag. At daang maluwag, ngunit sa dulo naman ay kapahamakan. We should not take our stand with sinners as if we are confirming our affiliation with them. Number 3, let us not sit in the seat of scoffers. Ano pong ibig sabihin ng seat? Seat means to dwell, to remain, to abide. This is dangerous, you know why? Because as if you have settled down, you become comfortable, content with the pattern of the world. Scoffers means to mock, to scorn, to talk arrogantly. Scoffers, these are the people who are putting down the things of God and His Word. Ito yung mga taong wala nang ibang ginawa kundi punahin ang gawain ng Diyos, ang kanyang salita. Kasama na rito ang hamakin ng kanyang mga lingkod. They do not have conviction anymore. Wala silang ibang gawin kundi hamakin ang gawain ng Diyos. Hamakin ang mga naglilingkod sa Diyos. We must not associate ourselves with these people. Sabi nga sa 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verse 33, do not be deceived. Bad company corrupts good morals. So, you are considered blessed if you do not walk, stand, and sit with the wicked. But that's not enough. Huh? It's not enough that you are not doing these things. aside from not doing these things, there are things that you should also do. Hindi po sapat na hindi mo ginagawa to, pero wala ka namang ginagawang tama. Huwag natin gawin itong mga ito, pero kailangan meron tayong gawing tama so that we will be considered blessed. So what are the things that we should do? Dalawa lamang po to. Number one, our delight should be in the law of the Lord. Delight means it gives pleasure, happiness, joy. Nagbibigay kilig ba sa puso mo ang salita ng Diyos? May matinding pagkauho ka ba sa salita ng Diyos? As if your day is not complete when you didn't read His Word. Your satisfaction is in His Word. Ito po yung ibig sabihin ng delight. Hindi ka papayag na hindi matatapos ang araw na to na hindi mo mababasa ang salita ng Diyos. Dahil para bang ang iyong araw ay hindi kumpleto kapag hindi ka nagbasa ng salita ng Diyos. Ito po ang ibig sabihin ng delight. Because the Word of God gives you satisfaction. The Word of God gives you pleasure. The Word of God gives you joy. Number two, meditate in His law day and night. We must be devoted to God's Word. Meditate it day and night. The word that they use here is meditate and not just read. Hindi po enough na nagbabasa lang tayo ng Biblia. Kailangan, we will meditate it. We will spend time. Hahalukayin natin, maghihintay tayo hanggang makareceive tayo ng salita, ng mensahe galing sa Diyos. You should receive the rema, the voice of God, yung mensahe niya po. So, as we read the Word of God, let us wait for God's message. Instead of finding pleasure in the world, or the ways of the fellowship of the wicked, the one who is truly blessed is the person who finds pleasure in meditating on the Word and the ways of God. Pero alam niyo po, after po nating hindi tayo nag-stand, nag-walk at nag-sit sa mga wicked, and we delight ourselves in the law of the Lord and we meditate it, God is so faithful that we will receive blessings. What are the blessings that the righteous will receive? Number one, you will become fruitful and prosperous. You are like a tree planted in the streams of water, which means you are fresh and has nutrition. You will become fruitful. What does it mean? You know, when a tree is fruitful, they are refreshing and nourishing to be around. You will be fed and strengthened. Because righteous people, their words are healing and convicting and encouraging and deepening and enlightening. Being around them is like a meal. This is the effect of delighting in the Word of God and meditating on it day and night. That is why kahit wala ka man sinasabi o ginagawa, pero ang mga tao na kakasalumuha mo, they will say na nabibless sila sa'yo. Because God's glory and anointing is with you. You are refreshing to be with. The way you live encourages other people. Your testimony brings inspiration. Another, whatever you do, wherever you go, the blessings will overtake you. Hindi ikaw ang nag-ahanap ng biyaya. Ikaw ang inahabol ng biyaya. Whatever you do, whatever you touch, it shall prosper. This is not just about financial blessing, but it means you are always useful and productive for the Lord. And lastly, wherever you go, God's blessing is with you. Number two, we become durable. Nagiging matatag at matibay tayo. When troubles come, we will not wither. It means we will not be shaken. Ano mang pagsubok o bagyo ang dumating sa ating buhay, hindi ka matitinag nito. Hindi ka matatakot at mapanghihinaan ng loob. Because we are rooted in His Word. And His Word make us durable. As we spend time to God's Word, we are strengthening our faith and dependence to Jesus. Kaya dumating man ang pagsubok, nananatiling matibay ang ating pananampalataya sa Kanya. For my conclusion po, we Christians are in the world, but we are not of the world. That is why let us not be a lover of the world, but instead, our delight should be in the Word, in His Word, and we must desire to walk by it. Lastly, let us always remember that our identity is in Christ. Let us follow the ways of God and not the ways of the wicked. Maraming salamat po, and let us close in prayer. Salamat o Diyos sa iyong kabutihan, sa iyong katapatan, sa aming mga buhay. Salamat o Lord na patuloy mo kami iniingatan, pinagpapala at pinoprovide ang lahat ng aming mga pangangailangan. Sa oras na to, we remember our nation, continually protect and guide our nation. Salamat po, O Lord, sa wisdom na pagkakalob mo sa aming presidente. Salamat po, O Lord, sa pag-iingat mo sa aming mga frontliners. At sa oras na to, pagpalain mo ang lahat ng nanonood ng live na to. Ano mang kanilang pangangailangan, you will provide with it, O Lord. Sino man dito ang nangangailangan ng kagalingan, you will give healing. Sino man ang nangangailangan ng financial breakthrough, marami pong salamat that you will provide for all their needs, O Lord. Sino man ang nangangailangan ng bagong trabaho, you will open doors of opportunity sa kanilang mga buhay. Marami pong salamat as we also remember our mentors and our leaders, continually bless them and anoint them. Thank you, O Lord, and bless the whole day, our whole day. This we ask and we pray in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen.